The Sea of Galilee is perhaps small in size, but huge in historical and religious significance. This ancient boat located at the Igal Alon Center in Kibbutz Genesar is one example of how each archaeological item found here is influential. Every year, thousands of Christian pilgrims flock to this small museum to see what some call the Jesus boat.
What's amazing about it is that it's made of wood and it sustained all these years in sweet water, which it's almost a miracle. It's not very easy to happen. And it gives us the opportunity to understand what was the size and what was the form of the boat that the fishermen that lived around here used to have in their daily job.
In 1986, Yuval and Moshe Lefen, two fishermen brothers from Kibbutz Genesar, found the boat. The effort to lift it and move it to the ground was difficult and complex. Radioactive testing showed that the boat dates back to between 100 BCE to 100 CE. These are the only remains of such a vessel from this era found in the Sea of Galilee, perhaps the closest evidence to the type of boat mentioned in the Gospels.
The fact that you go and sail yourself on the Sea of Galilee and go to see the churches that are related to his miracles and then see an actual boat that was found and that have to do exactly with these days, it's a very, very big excitement. And that's why in a normal year before COVID, we used to have around 200,000 pilgrims a year, which is a lot. So it's very, very exciting. You can see here people, you know, with shiny eyes look at the boat and actually try to imagine how it was 2,000 years ago.
Other items which were found near the boat were pottery and nails, dating back to the 1st century CE. Another interesting detail is that the boat is made out of 12 different kinds of wood.
One of the type of woods that we found here, its botanical name is the Christus spinus, and it's the same one that used to have the throne of Jesus. So again, it's a kind of a wood that we have here. It's a type of a wood that we used to know in this area. But have it in this boat, it gives this symbolism some, you know, even deeper meaning.
The boat is located at the Igal Alon Center, a museum and an educational institution. Here we can also find a piece of a famous mosaic from the synagogue of Hukuk, dating back to between the 4th and 6th centuries. But the center is mostly dedicated to Igal Alon, a legendary Israeli military commander, and a politician who believed in coexistence and peace.
We tried to give his legacy to the public, both in a 1.5-hour tour and also in longer activities that we do with students and with soldiers and with the elderly. And we try to give life to the values that he believed in, that we believe that are very, very relevant to the Israeli society today.
Over the years, Christian tourists have come to see this boat as a part of a pilgrimage tour, which sometimes includes sailing on the Sea of Galilee on the footsteps of Jesus. The Gospels say that some of Jesus' disciples were fishermen, and we can find many quotes related to boats in the New Testament. One of the most famous appears in the Gospel of Matthew. And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." When they had crossed over, they landed at Gennesaret. And when the men of that place recognized Jesus, they sent word to all the surrounding country. People brought all their sick to him and begged him to let the sick people just touch the edge of his cloak. And all who touched it were healed.